Today we would be talking about the poem The Chariot by Emily Dickinson. Emily Dickinson is an American poetess and she has written many poems and her poems were published after her death and she became very famous for her poems and her poems are very precise. They are very thoughtful, they are very imaginative, they are very innovative and they adopt a very different type of versification, rhyme scheme, use of images. She is famous for coining different type of images, different types of metaphors, and sometimes she is compared to the metaphysical poets of the 17th century. And her poems are ranging from day-to-day experiences to very much spiritual experiences, and she's at times very realistic, at times very meditative, at times quite metaphysical, beyond the physical. And in this poem also, when she's talking of chariot, she's at the same point of time using the metaphor of a chariot as a carriage to death, something which is carrying her or carrying the person who is speaking in this poem in a carriage which is driven by horses to eternity. But yet the destination or the goal to eternity is being awaited by the speaker, and it is wished by the speaker that she or he attains that goal, but they are moving with the horse's head towards eternity, but they have still not reached eternity. Now as the poem moves, the chariot, it runs like this: because I could not stop for death, he kindly stopped for me. Death has been personified as a gentleman, and because I could not stop for death, the speaker says this, or the poetess says this, because I could not stop for death. It seems one is too busy to attain death. He kindly stopped for me. Death is very gentle, and this gentleman of a person, death, stopped for the speaker. The carriage held but just ourselves. The carriage held but just ourselves and immortality. Now the speaker and immortality, they are being carried by the carriage. We slowly drove. He knew no haste. Now the person or death does not know any haste. Death is not in a hurry. And I had put away my labor, my leisure too, for his civility. Now it seems there was great deal of labor, there was great deal of leisure, but they have been put away for his civility, for as a response to the civic or to the civilized behavior of the person who is carrying the speaker. We passed the school where children played. Now these are the stages of life, and the speaker is passing these various stages of life, and this there is a picture of or image of a carriage which is being driven, and there are children who are playing, their lessons scarcely done. Now this is the usual scene where children are going to school, they are playing, and they are not studying as much as they should be. We passed the fields of gazing rain, we passed the setting sun. Now they are passing the day, and it is the time of setting sun. It is the time of setting sun, the day is coming to end. In the same way, the life of the speaker has also come to an end, from childhood to the period or the age when the speaker is being taken away by death. We paused before a house that seemed a swelling of the ground. The roof was scarcely visible, the cornice but a mound. Now there is almost a skeleton of the house. We paused before a house that seemed a swelling of the ground. Now that house has become a swelling, it is almost like a grave. The roof was scarcely visible, the cornice but a mound. And all the corners or the roof which gives you protection, they have turned into a mound. Now there is a mound or a grave which has remained. Since then it's centuries, but each feels shorter than the day. Now since the death or the stages of life and the death, since then it's been centuries, but each feels shorter than the day. I first surmised the horse's head were towards eternity. I was mounting into this carriage and we were moving towards eternity. So the eternity, which was a goal after death, it has not been achieved. But the saving factor is they are moving towards and they are heading towards. They are moving in the right direction. They are heading in the right direction. Now, Emily Dickinson's poems, they reflect a faith, a great faith in Christianity. And somewhere this faith has been re-established in this poem. And the poetess is sure or is hopeful or is wishful that she attains eternity, or the speaker of the poem attains eternity. And as the faith is that after death the soul attains eternity, so the soul goes to heaven and it attains eternity. So in the same faith the poetess is echoing that we are moving towards eternity and we would attain it. But Emily Dickinson somewhere is still not so happy or is so convinced that she would attain eternity, and she says that yes, we are moving in the direction, but we have still not attained eternity. And besides this, death, which was very gentle in the beginning, when the speaker moves with death, it somewhere is becoming little bit unfriendly and not all that civilized as it was in the initial stanzas. So somewhere the death becomes stern, or the death who has taken away the life from this earth becomes stern. But at the same point of time, the death is inevitable. The journey of life is inevitable. The journey of the soul after death is inevitable. And the poetess' faith in Christianity, in Jesus Christ, and in God, and in immortality is there. It has not been shaken. Although there is a question, or although there is again in the end things have been left without being answered positively or negatively, as the chariot is moving, or its heads, horses' heads are towards eternity, but the eternity has not been achieved. Now in this whole poem there are so many visual images of a person being carried away in a chariot. Then there are images of school children playing. Then there are images of fallen buildings, fallen houses, graves. Then there are images of people traveling, and still the travelers or the pilgrims have not reached their goals. So the whole poem is a metaphor of journey of life or journey after death, and this metaphor is being described in the various lines of the poem, but the thought is almost same, the journey of the soul after death. Thank you.